Hey guys, welcome to another episode in the deep playthrough of Dark Souls 3. Still endlessly trying to get three Millwood Knights in a row. With, I think, soul level 58 and Estoc plus 7. And they really hit incredibly hard. And I don't want to cheese my way past them. I want to get them the way it's supposed to be done. God damn it, again I'm missing them. Titanite chunk, nice! I was not aware these guys also threw dropped chunks. God damn it, still hit by the because this, again, is a millisecond. If I would have gotten the parry, I would have been invincible frames. That earthquake thing, I mean, I will just try and continue, but it's so annoying because it's out of your control whether you die or not. It literally is so annoying. If you have like the ground exploding beneath you, but you do have to stay still to hit someone, yeah, then something's gotta give. This guy again. Quickly back at him. But this is what I mean with that earthquake. What can I do about this? Literally nothing. I hit, that he didn't hit me, but somehow he staggered me while he didn't touch me. And then he followed up with a kill blow. It's... And it's again those fucking earthquakes. I was starting well. I had a parry, everything was going nice, and then boom, you're up in the air. This guy is also falling down. Come on, come over here. Don't fall down. God damn it. I could try and fight him just for fun over here. This dude in the earthquake zone, it's so annoying. Because you'll have to take a little bit of distance before you go in, otherwise he does like this bash. And it's the same also with that other dude with the shield. The problem with him is, of course, I can avoid the earthquakes. Just circle around him when the time is totally right, go in for a parry. Although there hardly is any time that is totally right, because those earthquakes are pretty much continuously. But the problem with that guy with the shield is he has regenerating health. So if I'm not totally on him, then got me. I think it was both a kill and the parry while I was dying. But anyway, it is just the setup of this fight, it's just unfair, because with that knight you have to stay close to him, otherwise he regenerates, but that means taking risks with those earthquakes, and that means that you simply die a lot outside of your mistake, outside of your control. It simply hope that the floor doesn't explode, and if so, bad luck for you. Chunk. Very nice. stagger. He's not even hitting me, but the character staggers and then he follows up. It's just super annoying. Maybe it's some kind of a war cry special ability. I don't know. I do know it's super annoying. And again, I've only gotten to the third one once in an hour of gameplay. It's not the best ratio, I would say. This way too anxious and in a reactive state. I must be much more proactive. They're big and they're intimidating, but actually they're not. You can just get those suckers. They have a limited moveset. And by now I know that moveset quite well. Also good to know that when they are in an aggro state, you can just dance them around that tree, I think. Although you do have to watch out for the earthquakes. This parried him at the right moment, I'm pretty damn certain. Holy shit. I looked off while I wanted to look on. Test out my holy shit, there are two of them. Holy shit. Right. I should not be too close by the X dude, because then he gets aggroed and joins the fight, which is not what you want. Yeah, damn it. The other motherfucker. Should have had that berry. course, my bad that I was too close that he could shield bash me. But I think even after the shield bash, I had a couple of times, you can still parry it. I think I hit it at the right time, but maybe I was out of stamina, I have no idea, but the parry didn't work. Missed that one. It's nobody's fault but mine. Happened last time. Shield bash and then trying to parry him, and yeah, this time I think I indeed pushed the parry button too early. But it's also because you know that you're also under threat from that earthquake stuff, just makes for such an annoying combination of things. fucking shield bash that gets me. I know I can parry him even after that bash, I think. I did it a couple of times, but now I'm dying three times in a row from the shield bash. At least I have his aggro phase pretty well figured out now. I can just bait him around in a circle. By the way, guys, I have to do one little culinary thing. I will be back in 20 seconds. Sorry, and a very quick sanitary stop. Back. Sorry for that. I had to put on my leftover dinner from yesterday evening. I made, like, for my doing, an amazing spaghetti. I had to put it on the stove. Here we go, no more kidding around. We're good. Out of the way from the earthquakes. Fuck me, big time. How long is this going to take? I'm just gonna keep at it until I do it. God damn it. You can get him, but he is so no stamina limits. flurry of swings, and there's such a big chance if you attack him that he attacks you later, but his attack has priority over yours. So annoying. But it's also because you just get impatient from constantly waiting here trying to pass him. And often it goes quite quickly, but sometimes he is kind of slow. And looking in your direction, then you have to wait so long. It's just annoying. What happened there? It almost looked like a totally new attack. That flurry, pretty. He was kneeling and overhead swinging left and right, and then one of those ground and pound attacks to finish it off. Not sure I've seen that one before. Maybe I'm making excuses that I just missed my parry, but it was a pretty wild attack. That he, I don't think, used that often. Here we go again. He's not following. I just missed that one. That was on me. And that was also not the best time to do an Estus. Horizontal swing that he does, I don't know if that is harder to parry than other swings, but it felt like it. Maybe I was not in the correct position, I have no idea. Or I just mistimed it. It's all possible. And it's a little bit annoying because I have the feeling that I will not get through this on skill alone. That I just need to have a little bit of luck. And then that doesn't feel right. If you pass something, but you know that it's not fully on your own account, on your own merit. Well, I think in Dark Souls 1, that was much more the case. If you feel Dark Souls 1, by the way, with luck, I'm not even meaning so much that it's only the earthquake that needs to fall right and stuff, but it's also just me. Consistent enough. And that shield bash. sure what hit me. But I still have 6 Estus. Not even that bad. Just casually running away instead of rolling and sprinting and stressing out. It's just rolling away or running away is enough to avoid 90% of those rage attacks, which is nice to know. Makes for a much, how do you say, relaxed fight. But I'm still doing way too less structural damage to him. I need to get to him as... Goddamn, I wanted to say... as consistent as I get this first guy. And then before I can even utter that sentence, he kills me. But... I'm way too inconsistent with that second one. Not even talking about the third one. Yeah, I think there's only one way to go, and that's perseverance wins the day, hopefully. Takes a bit of time and effort. Although, I must say, on a very weird level, I'm also enjoying this. While it's super repetitive, I'm not sure what that's all about. Just a bit weird. I should have gotten that one. Alright, this is getting a little bit crazy, to be quite honest. How often I'm failing over here. I think it's already, I don't know, 6-7 episodes. Me failing. Seriously. Alright, almost hitting the 45 minute marker. I really would like to continue as long as it takes, but unfortunately real life is calling as well. Is coming as well or not? Maybe not. Take my chance. I know he's on. He's on top of her because I see. Distracted by that other guy and I'm just totally screwing it up. I think he was on top of that little tunnel because I saw his flame somehow, his torch light somehow below in the tunnel. So I was actually expecting him to drop down any minute as well. So this is already like 2 or 3 totally useless attempts. Not even getting past this guy. Here we have him again. Here, he's so annoying. Alright, just kill me. I maybe even find this guy more annoying than the Millwood Knights, to be honest. He is so annoying. Because he hardly has any opening. And even if you find an opening, he just attacks later and it overrides your own attack which started earlier. That enemy is really, really, really. Yeah, excusez le mot, but fucked up. Thank you. still parrying. Alright, last try of the evening, or at least of now. What the hell? Are you kidding me? Theory whether only casually running away is enough to dodge his rage attacks, and he immediately kills me with a rage attack while running away. So the answer is no. But yeah, I have to end the episode here, guys. We'll continue relentlessly, tirelessly, and numb and aimlessly in the next episode. Guys, hope you still enjoyed. Hope to see you there. For the meantime, don't forget, you yourself as well, always do keep on gaming. See you later.